So today's Sky Factory video is going to be a little bit different than normal. I thought I'd go ahead and make a little montage of me farming stuff while I give you guys a little bit of a story time. I don't know if I'll do any more of these story time videos, but if you guys enjoy, please do leave a like and let me know in the comment section. And if this is your first time around here, please do consider subscribing and turning on that notification bell. Anyways, let's go ahead and get right into it. So this story time takes place back in 8th grade, where everyone knows that middle school was the time where you were depressed for no reason. Doesn't matter if there was something that caused it, or if it's just the fact that you're in school and you're stressed out, everyone was depressed. We all hate to admit it, but it's true. And the worst part about it is that the teachers don't really make it easier for you. It's either a faculty member or a teacher, but for me, it was the bus driver. Towards the beginning of the year, we had a pretty cool laid-back bus driver, and he got along with a couple of the kids on the bus. But he ended up retiring right in the middle of the year, so we had to get a new bus driver. So for the first couple months of having a new bus driver, I was okay with it. It was pretty decent, they didn't have any problems, until a little bit later on into the year where she started becoming a little bit too much. And I will admit, on every bus, there are those kids that decide to just stand up when they're not supposed to, and she has to tell them to sit down. But she kind of did it in a mean way rather than just worrying for their safety. She would always yell at them when they wouldn't sit down, and I think that's not the way to do it. She would always yell at them to sit down instead of politely telling them to, and that's not right. So yeah, there are some places where it was the kid's fault rather than her fault, but if we're being honest, no teacher should ever be talking to a kid like that, let alone a bus driver. So how does this story involve me, you may be asking? Well, let me tell you. So when I was on the bus, I usually sat a little bit closer to the back of the bus, and as you can probably tell, that means I was probably near the people that were troublemakers. So naturally, I was associated with them in a way. One day I was just listening to music, had my headphones in, just minding my own business, and then I randomly hear some kid just scream out the F word. And you would assume that she would handle the situation like a calm, civilized person, right? Well, instead of just telling them on the intercom to watch their language, she came back and confronted, you guessed it, me. She literally thought that I was the kid that said the F word out loud. And let me tell you right now, I am not one to swear. I am a Christian, I don't swear. I'm usually a pretty good kid. So the next morning, she decided to sit me in the front of the bus, along with another kid that she was targeting. And she told me that this would be where I sit for the rest of the year. And when I asked her why, she just told me that I need to watch my language. So me being innocent, I told my mom about it, and we told the school board. And the next day, she told me I could sit wherever I wanted, because I was innocent. And this wasn't the only time she targeted me. She would always come up to me and tell me to calm down and sit down and just stay in my seat when I was doing nothing wrong. And it got to the point where I had to tell everyone in my family about it, and my sister even confronted her at one point. My sister and I took the same bus to school, and then she would get onto another bus that would transfer her from my school to a different school. But one day she decided to stay on the bus so that she could talk to her after everyone got off. She asked her why she was targeting me and why she was just picking on me for doing all the bad stuff when I wasn't doing nothing wrong. And when she tried to explain herself, she just started stumbling on her words and not even giving a good reason. My sister told me that when she told her what happened, all she did was say, "Well, he just needs to learn respect. He's being very loud and he needs to watch his language when he's on the bus." So basically, she was just making stuff up because she had never been confronted like this before. And I would assume that after that, she would just leave me alone, right? Well, the next day, I got confronted again by her. Now, a little context. In the morning, I'm very tired and I don't want to talk to anyone. So I just sit there with my AirPods in and I just sit there by myself, just not talking. And in the afternoon, if I have friends that are on the bus, then I'll talk to them and I'll be a little bit more awake and crazy. But one day I was getting shoved on the bus because everyone was making a big crowd to get on the bus instead of making a single file line. And then I just yelled out to everyone to stop shoving. And then when it got to me getting on the bus, she looked at me and gave me a little bit of attitude. She literally came up to me and was like, "Why aren't you acting like that when your sister's on the bus?" I just shook my head and shrugged. I didn't know what she was talking about. And when I was walking even further onto the bus, I heard her say, "That's what I thought." So this attitude was clearly inappropriate. So I decided the next day I would report her to the office. I went ahead and reported her, and I went home quietly the next day. And then the next day when I got on the bus, she wasn't there. It was someone else. And I kind of felt like I did something. I kind of wondered, did I get her fired? But then I found out later on that day that it wasn't me that got her fired. It was just some other kid that was really getting mad about her, always targeting him and all that stuff. And he cussed her out a little bit. So she quit. I guess she couldn't handle all the kids being so mean to her, I guess, even though she was the one that was mean to us. But yeah, the new guy wasn't really that much better. He was still kind of mean to us and he swore at a kid. But hey, I would rather someone that swears at a couple kids rather than someone that targets me all the time. Honestly, if you're a bus driver and you have to deal with kids all day, I honestly respect you for dealing with all of that because that's a pretty hard job. But just know your place and just don't bother the kids, because I know that it can be difficult to deal with them all day and have to just drive them everywhere while they're being wild on the bus. But you literally have one job, which is to get us home safely. So unless you're getting physically attacked or verbally attacked by these kids, just don't talk to them, don't be a bully to them, and just do your job. Because you didn't sign up to be their babysitter. You signed up to be their bus driver. A taxi or an Uber driver wouldn't tell their guests to just shut their mouths while they're driving. So why should you? And if you're a kid that has experienced this kind of stuff from a bus driver, definitely report it. It's better to just report the problem rather than waiting for nothing to happen. But anyways, guys, that's where I'm gonna end this story time. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and if you did, please do leave a like and consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.